So I'm going to do something a bit different today on Crypto Scam Watch, and I want to have a look at Electrum malware versus a hardware wallet. So as you can see, we have the oldest official version of Electrum that is still susceptible to the full rich text phishing experience. Alrighty, let's get phished. We'll just send a tiny transaction to the next address, which is just password, signing, broadcasting. Ah, here we go. So this is the error. So notice there's no signatures or anything like that that we want. And because we're running the old version of Electrum, we can just have the clickable HTML straight in the app. So let's just say we want the standalone executable for Windows, because the electrumbay.org isn't even slightly sus. But anyway, let's just go along with it. Well, since that's taking forever, let's just click on their website and have a look and see what other versions they've got available to scam us. Yeah, why not? Let's download the signature and see. Okay, so we've got our scammy version of Electrum. It took a while to download, but now we're good. So just out of curiosity, let's see how it goes if I try and verify it. There we go, surprise, surprise. So the malware version could not be verified. What a shame. Let's just run it anyway and see what happens. Okay, so it's letting us send. So we can preview the transaction. Ah. That's very interesting. If we have a look, we can see this scammy version of Electrum is actually sending to a different output other than the one that we have specified in the software. So if we say sign, I'm curious to see. Here we go. So that wants me to enter the password. So we'll just do that. And I'm guessing as soon as I give it the password, all hell's going to break loose. So we've signed the transaction. And hey, look, we'll just save that one for later. Okay, so now let's try the same thing with the hardware wallets. So we want one Satoshi per byte. We want to send everything, and we want to send it to the next address. So let's hit preview and see what we get. There we go. So it is definitely going to a different address. So this is exactly the same behavior as we saw in the other one. And so here's the really important thing. So if I'm using my ledger and I hit sign, my ledger is now telling me, let's have a look. So the amount is correct. The address is not even close. So yes, we can see here, so the address that we're being asked to send to is actually the same one that's being listed here in the transaction for Electrum. So that's a really good example of just taking the time to pay attention to the output screen on your hardware wallet, which immediately makes it obvious that something is going wrong. Because if you were to just stick in the address you're going to pay to and hit send, you'd actually get no indication that you're sending it to the wrong address if you're just using a software wallet. So with this wallet, this software wallet that's unlocked and working and ready to go, if I hit send right now, it will simply send it to the wrong address. Whereas with my hardware wallet, even if I don't hit preview, when I hit send, it will say confirm it on my ledger. And if I look on my ledger now, the pay to address is completely different to what is just here on the screen, which to me, I'm like, no, we're not going to send that. And there you go. So defeated. I think it's worth saying, like, who knows what else a loaded up piece of malware like this is going to do, hence why I'm going to blow this virtual machine away as soon as I'm done. But I think this is a really good example of the extra security that a second screen on a hardware wallet gives you, in that although the scammer might be able to trick you into thinking you're sending it to the wrong address, they can't trick your hardware wallet in terms of which address it's signing a transaction for. So that is a really good example of that. So I've just used a Ledger Nano S in this example. And look, if you don't have a hardware wallet and this has made you maybe think that that's a good idea, I've got a link for how to get them in the description. Definitely best just to order them straight from the manufacturer. And it should be said that, you know, a Trezor would have done this just as well. And I own both, so I'm not really biased one way or the other. This is also a really good example of exactly how Clipboard malware will work, in that there is a malware out there that what it will do is it will detect that there's a Bitcoin address or something like that in your clipboard, and so it'll swap it out with the scammer's address. So you'll think you're sending your funds to someone else when really you're sending them to the scammer. And if you're paying attention to where you should be sending the funds and checking that on your hardware wallet, then that can be a really powerful way to stop getting scammed from those sorts of scams too. I hope that gives you a really good idea about what to look for in terms of the current Electrum phishing scams that are out there. And at the very least, you need to update your version of Electrum if you're not running one higher than 3.34. But at the end of the day, no matter how badly compromised your wallet software is or even your whole operating system, there's really nothing any of that malware can do that would cause your hardware wallet to display fake amounts of cryptocurrency and fake addresses on its own screen. So as long as you take the time to check that the address on the screen matches where you think it should be going, you've got a really powerful advantage there that there's really nothing scammers can do to damage. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Just hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make to help people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. Or if there's a question you'd like some more information about or a topic you'd like me to cover in the future, just leave a reply.